Hello and welcome to our Do You series. We've looked at questions such as do you fear and do you believe? And today we're going to be looking at when Jesus asked, do you want? There are plenty of amazing accounts of healing in the Bible, and we've looked at some of them. Jesus has healed loads of different people, all who believed that he could heal them, and we looked at some of them last week. And today we're going to look at another time Jesus came across someone who needed healing. So why don't we take a little look at what is going on?
God's story, the Pool of Bethesda. So part of God's story is about a trip Jesus took to a part of Jerusalem called Bethesda. And it begins like this. Jesus was returning to Jerusalem to celebrate a big Jewish holiday. Now, Jesus had done some really incredible things since the last time he was there. He turned water into wine, threw dishonest merchants out of God's temple, healed a young boy about to die, and taught lots of people about God. While Jesus was in Jerusalem, the next part of his mission was to visit the Pool of Bethesda. But this isn't the kind of pool you might be thinking of. There was no sunscreen, no swimsuits, and no big diving board for cannonballs. This was a place of sickness and pain. Blind, crippled, and paralyzed people came to the pool, waiting and hoping to be healed. See, there was a popular story that an angel with healing powers would come down and stir the water, and the first person to touch the water would be cured of whatever was hurting them. Some of the people had waited there for years, maybe even decades, hoping that one day they would be healed. Unfortunately, this story about the angel wasn't true. The pool didn't have special powers, and it wasn't going to heal anyone. But Jesus' power is real, and it can heal people. Jesus saw a man who had been sick for 38 years. He asked the man, "Would you like to get well?" That probably seemed a little weird since everyone around the pool was there to be healed. But the man answered anyway. "I can't, sir," the man replied. He had waited by the pool hoping to get healed, but because he couldn't walk, someone always made it to the pool before him. So he thought he could never be healed. But remember, the pool didn't have any power, so it wouldn't have healed him anyway. What the man didn't know was that he wouldn't have to wait for healing any longer. Jesus simply said, "Stand up, pick up your mat, and walk." And then the man did. Instantly, he was healed. Then Jesus left, disappearing into the crowd. Kids, have you ever waited for something for a really long time? Later, Jesus found the man in the temple and told him, "Now you are well, so stop sinning, or something even worse may happen to you." Jesus didn't just want to heal the man's body. He wanted to heal his heart, because he loved him. And the coolest part? Even though we mess up and disobey God, Jesus loves us and wants to heal our hearts too. And that's the story of Jesus at the Pool of Bethesda. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Jesus went to Jerusalem. Jesus went to the Pool of Bethesda. Sick people gathered around the pool to be healed. A man had been waiting 38 years. Jesus healed him. Jesus told the man to stop sinning because he loved him. Jesus loves us too. And that's a part of God's story.
Wow. In the Bible, there are 22 separate recorded times that Jesus healed people. But each time I read about it or hear about it, it doesn't make it any less amazing. Here in John chapter 5, we learned that every day, people came to the Pool of Bethesda for a chance of being healed. And when you go to the doctors and you sit outside, you wait to be seen. And if you have to go to the accident and emergency department of the hospital, you sit in the waiting room. And depending on how ill or hurt you are and how busy the doctors are, you get seen quicker or you have to wait longer. Well, this wasn't like that at all. I remember a few years ago, I got really hurt and we had to go to the doctors and wait a little while. But within an hour, I was being seen by a doctor and they gave me crutches and medication, and that all happened really quickly. And perhaps on a bad day, you'd have to wait a few hours to get seen. But this man had been waiting 38 years at his chance for getting better. I can't imagine waiting that long for anything. I haven't even been alive that long. And he was in a bit of a pickle though, wasn't he? To get healed, they thought you had to be first to the water when it started stirring up. And this man couldn't even walk. I think by now we can say that Jesus is amazing at asking the most unexpected questions, isn't he? In the middle of a storm where these fishermen thought that they were going to die because it was so violent and scary, and they were asking Jesus why he was so calm, and he turned around and he asked them, why are you so afraid? And here we see he comes to this man who's been waiting to get better for almost 40 years, and he asks a completely unexpected question. If I met this man, I might ask, what happened? Does it hurt? Why are you waiting by this pool of water? But Jesus doesn't ask any of those. Instead, he asks, do you want to be well? This man has been waiting by the water for 38 years at a chance to get better. I think it's safe to say that he wants to get better. It's a funny question to ask, but like everything that Jesus did, if you think about it, it starts to make sense. If something is bad or is a problem, it's making us upset or angry, or if we're hurt, ignoring it isn't going to make it go away. And I've heard that a lot. Ignoring a problem won't make it go away. And you've probably been told that by someone, or even maybe you've said that to someone in the past. And sitting by the water for 38 years had done nothing for this man. But all it took was for him to let Jesus know what he wanted, and that was to get better. And with a simple sentence, he was healed. Instead of ignoring things and hoping that they will go away, Jesus wants us to want, to go ahead and ask, to speak to God in prayer and talk to him, to tell him what is going on. If we're struggling with something, we shouldn't ignore it or do something that might perhaps maybe help us one day. Jesus wants us to do something. And doesn't it make so much more sense that we should go to the one who can do amazing things? And God has all this amazing power. He wants to help us, but he also wants us to ask for help. So next time you need help with something, remember, you can always go to God for help. All you need to do is pray. Thank you so much for joining us this week, and I hope to see you next week. Goodbye.